I'm going to share the 5 mistakes that I see most new video editors make, destroying the quality of their footage and wasting valuable time while doing it. I'm also going to share some tips to help you avoid those mistakes. Tutorial links for any tips I share will be in the video description. Let's clean up those filthy little videos. Mistake number one is not having a video editing process. A lot of people jump right into the video and start adding effects, color grading, or tweaking the audio. The first thing that you need to do is make sure that you have all the content necessary to tell your story and deliver your message to your viewer. Adding things like effects, transitions, and doing color grading uses resources. These things slow down your PC as well as your editing software. So it's best to do these things at the end of the video editing process. If you want to see my step-by-step editing process, hang out until the end of the video and I'll share a link to that tutorial. The second mistake most new video editors make is over-editing. Understandably, a lot of new editors get excited about their newfound ability to create. Unfortunately, this excitement could lead to new editors using too many effects or using too many transitions. Some may even create too many cuts or use the wrong type of cut for the situation. The only thing that over-editing does is annoy your viewer and make them move on to a different video. Unless the effect is completely necessary, stay away from using effects. Only use transitions when they fit the video, and even then you should be using them sparingly. Try to use simple cuts as much as possible. If you need help understanding different cuts and when to use them, check out the linked video in the card above. Third on our list of mistakes is not saving backups of your project. Most new editors edit on one version of their project. If you're not saving different versions of your project along the way as you're editing, you're putting your entire project in danger. If your project becomes corrupt or you delete your entire project by mistake, everything's lost. When you create new projects along the way as you edit, you're creating redundancy, which allows you to go back to different versions of your project if something happens to go wrong. As you go through the editing process, you should be saving your project with a new name or with a new version number as you go through each step. Check out the video linked in the card above to learn several ways to save videos and when to use each one. The fourth mistake on our list is not practicing good file management. You have to organize your files so you can be as efficient as possible while editing. Taking a little bit of time up front to organize things makes it easier to find things while you're editing. If you ever need to retrieve an old project, it makes it easier to find things as well. Also, when you're collaborating with someone, you can share your project with them and they can easily find what they need. I've included a card with the link to my media management tutorial if you want to learn more. Mistake number five is not learning keyboard shortcuts. Learning and using keyboard shortcuts will speed up your editing workflow. Shortcuts are more efficient because they replace what you normally do with multiple mouse clicks by pressing buttons on your keyboard. Using keyboard shortcuts of actions that you do repeatedly, such as split, play, reverse, forward, and more, are game changers for new video editors who aren't using them. You can do a Google search for keyboard shortcuts, followed by the name of your editor to find a list of several keyboard shortcuts, or you can check out the shortcut linked in this card to see 14 simple shortcuts to speed up your workflow using PowerDirector. Earlier in the video, I talked about the importance of having a step-by-step editing process. If you want to know my 8 steps that you need to create better video, check out this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.